Welcome back. Get ready to get your sweet tooth on with Sally McKenney. She is the author of this new book, Sally's Baking Addiction, and boy, does she have one, and she's going to share it with us this morning. Good morning.
Yes, good morning. Thank you for having me.
You're so welcome, Sally. So tell us about your cookbook. It's absolutely beautiful.
Thank you. It's just an example of how much I love to bake and be in the kitchen.
And this is really what you do full time. You used to be in corporate finance, but then you decided to turn your passion into profit, really.
Yeah, turn my favorite hobby into my full-time job, and it was a lot of work, and it's awesome.
Okay, and you're going to show us something very easy to make this morning.
Yes, yeah, I'm going to make a marshmallow swirl chocolate fudge. It's so easy, just 5 ingredients, no baking, no candy thermometer, the easiest recipe in my cookbook. So
yeah, thank goodness.
Yeah, so it starts with chocolate chips and sweetened condensed milk and butter.
All right, we're going to tip your pan here just a minute so you can see how thick that is. And that's what I love is it.
Super
thick. Only chocolate chips, that's it.
Yes.
Condensed milk, about a cup.
Yep, a cup of condensed milk and butter. Yep, and
one stick?
Half a stick.
Half a stick, okay.
Total health food.
All right, totally.
Yeah, totally. So just melt it all together until it's completely smooth, and then we're going to remove it from heat just for a couple minutes. I'll just put it on this one. And we're going to gently stir in 2 cups of mini marshmallows and 4 full-size graham crackers. And we're just going to pour them
in. Hold that for
you. Thank you.
Just stick it in there?
Yeah.
All right.
And just gently stir it all together. You don't want the marshmallows to fully melt because you want to create those swirls like we have here. So just gently stir it all together and try not to get it on the stove.
Stirring it up. Let's talk about some of the recipes in your cookbook because each one comes with a full-size picture of what it's supposed to look like, and it's absolutely gorgeous. And you have how many recipes in this book?
75.
Wow, and everything from chocolate to fruit tarts, you name it, it's in here.
Yes, it's full of desserts.
Full of desserts, and it's nice that you included pictures with them all, and they all seem really relatively easy to make, too.
They're all so simple. I mean, I'm a self-taught baker, so I definitely want some easy recipes in there.
Banana chocolate chip layer cake.
I love banana, yes.
Oh, yeah. And so let's talk about some of the food that you brought with you. You have the cupcakes.
Yep, so I have mini vanilla cupcakes here with sprinkles on top, of course. And I have rainbow chocolate chip cookies, the softest cookies you're ever going to eat, trust me. Lemon bars, very simple, perfect for springtime and Easter. Double chocolate muffins, which are one of my favorite muffins.
Oh, yeah.
So good when they're warm. And white chocolate macadamia nut blondies.
Oh, yeah. I can see the big macadamia nuts in there. Okay, so while you continue to stir, tell me what your secret is for super soft chocolate chip cookies.
Cornstarch. I add a little bit of cornstarch. It makes them so soft. And I also underbake them ever so slightly.
Underbaking.
That's my secret.
Okay, so once you get everything melted in there, what do you do?
Now we're going to pour it into our square baking pan and see those gorgeous swirls in there. So we're just going to pour it in, and I line the baking pan with aluminum foil because that way after it chills in the refrigerator, you can kind of lift all of the fudge right out and cut it easily into squares. So it's going to take about 4 to 6 hours to chill in the refrigerator.
No baking, you chill
it. Oh, no, definitely no baking involved here. Very easy, perfect for like the summertime when you want s'mores.
Sally McKenney from Elkridge with your new cookbook. Thank you so much for coming in. We appreciate it.
Thank you.
You have a blog.
Thank you. Delicious. Yes, I have a blog too, sallysbakingaddiction.com.